Welcome back to another episode of Damn It, Hoshi! I'm just kidding. Hoshi, my 2010 Subaru Forester, has been periodically, ever since I replaced the short block, flashing a check engine light with engine misfire codes. So this is actually, we just got back from Florida. She flashed a check engine light with a misfire on all four cylinders in Florida. She flashed it again when we got back home to Ohio. So those check engine light codes that we've been getting that tell us that we're having the misfires is the P series code. P0301 is misfire on cylinder one, 302, cylinder two. Those were the common codes I was getting. This time around, I got on my scan gauge, it was telling me P0000, which is, I now know, code for a misfire on all four cylinders. So it's not just one and two, it's all of them now. So I took it up to Kings Subaru, and one of the technicians there suggested that I check the exhaust valve guide pins. So for those of you new to mechanics, those are actually inside the heads. The exhaust valves actually allow for air to escape the piston into the exhaust lines. It's really easy to diagnose, so that's what we're working on today. Step one is to unplug your O2 sensors from the top of the engine. Step two is to just remove your catalytic converter or exhaust manifold. And step three is the actual diagnosis of looking up in the header to check for those exhaust guide pins. So we've broken all the bolts, and all we have to do is undo a few screws and pull the catalytic converter off, which, if you're interested in catalytic converters, we have two-part series on that.
That was a fun series.
Free. Be free, kitty.
Hold on, I don't want to hit you and I don't want to hit anything else.
Yep, it's got to tilt up that way. Yeah. All right, there we go. Gasket. So obviously we got the catalytic converter off. In order to diagnose the exhaust valve guide pins, you're gonna remove your exhaust manifold and look up into the heads. What you're gonna see is you're going to see the actual valve in the head that runs the exhaust gases out of the cylinder head when the car is obviously firing. Those guide pins hold those little valves in the correct position. What happens sometimes, chronically with Subarus apparently, is those little guide pins fall out of position. When they fall out of position, that causes the little valve to not operate exactly within the parameter, which causes a misfire. And within the Subarus, apparently sometimes they slide out of position, cause a misfire, and then get put back in position through the normal cause of the engine operating. So it comes and goes. It's extremely intermittent. It's hard to diagnose. Sometimes you'll be sitting there thinking, oh, it's a misfire, so something has to be drastically wrong with the car, but it runs fine. What we found with our Forester is that the guide pins are indeed out of position. They're sliding in and out. We can see wear on a few of the valves. So we're gonna try to show you what that wear looks like if you're trying to diagnose your own exhaust valve guide pins. So here we have the actual valve stem that you see coming out, and this little black cap here is the guide. Now this looks pretty normal, so this one looks all right. Now let's go to one that looks obviously bad to us. So this is the bad exhaust valve, and in between the valve stem and the black cap, you see there's a little bit of shiny metal from the actual valve.
It looks like a black line.
Right, of bare metal. So that's an indicator that the guide pin has been falling in and out of position, causing the misfires. So we have bad exhaust valve guide pins. What that means, because we have a Subaru, is that we need to buy all new heads. No! What I've been told by the technician at Kings Subaru is that this is a problem in Subarus specifically, where machine shops cannot simply refit the guides without them running into this exact same problem shortly after doing the work. Unfortunately, because a machine shop can't do it and they've got years of experience, this isn't something that Art and I are going to try to remanufacture on the heads. What we're going to end up doing is just buying all new heads and doing a very large engine job. And I laugh a little bit because we know exactly how to do this work, but unfortunately it's not going to be cheap. And it involves pulling the engine simply because it's going to be easiest to do the head bolts that way. We're going to get new head gaskets. We're going to do a new timing belt while we're in there. We may as well go ahead and upgrade the oil pump and work on some other things that were on the to-do list, but we haven't made it a priority. Thanks for joining us. Hope you enjoy our content. Drop us a comment, questions. We'd love to engage with you, and we'll catch you next time. Bye.